So I think this leaves us in a position where we can actually state the Td1 update rule. So it looks a little hairy, but we're going to be able to go through it and see that it does something very sensible, or at least somewhat sensible. So this is the structure of the rule of Td1. So for each time we start a new episode, we're going to initialize this thing called the eligibility, E of S, for all the states to zero. So we just start them off as ineligible at the start of the episode, and we start off our estimate for the value function for this episode to be initialized to whatever it was at the end of the previous episode.
That makes sense.
So then, each time we take a step within the episode, a step from some s little t minus 1 to some state s little t, getting reward rt, what we're going to do is first update the eligibility of the state that we just left, then go through all the states, compute this one quantity, which is the same for all states. This is the temporal difference. This is the difference between, or the sum of the reward plus the discounted value of the state that we just got to, minus the state that we just left. And we're going to use the values of the, you know, that we had from the previous iteration, the previous episode. That's going to be our temporal difference. And we're going to apply that temporal difference to all states proportional to the eligibility of those states and, of course, the learning rate, because we don't want to move too much. And we're just going to update them by that. We're going to increase them by this temporal difference times the eligibility. Then we decrease or decay the eligibility for those states. And then we're back up to the next step.
Okay. It's got all the right letters, so I think I can imagine that this will do something. So the for all S part, does that have to be done in a specific order?
No, because the S's are all being done in parallel here. So the value at state S is going to be updated based on this quantity, which is the same for everybody. It doesn't depend on which S we're currently updating. And this quantity, which is specific to the S that we're looking at. So it's all kind of happening in parallel without any dependencies between them.
Yeah, okay, I see. So because there's an order to the states and the way we're going to visit them, you basically get to see that value kind of applied everywhere. Okay, I think I understand.
Okay, all right, so let's kind of step this through in a tiny little example and then see the magic of it, see that it actually produces the same outcome that we would have gotten with the update rule that we had talked about previously.
Okay,